behind me here to the north, but they don't seem to cause me as much bother as whatever's cutting me out to the south. To be honest about that, Marty, I'd be lucky if I can get a wee bit past Rahada, Roger.
No bother at all. Yep. Well, I didn't know there what way you were going there. I mind the way back, Joan. Did you ever get the Kenwood fixed? I mind something happened to Kenwood there. I hadn't been speaking to you a long time, and I think we were using the wee 2830 or something, over.
Aye, indeed. I was using the President Lincoln there. I was using it for a while, and then I got a replacement Kenwood 870. So I've got two of them. I've got two of them now. And the old 870. It still needs to be repaired, Marty. I have full intentions of sending it over to Wales, over to what do you call it? I can't think of the name of the group now, but the chap's Jeff. Is it Jeff? Yeah, Jeff Wainwright. Wayne House. Yeah. I hope to send the 870 over to him now. That's just me, Marty, putting it on the long finger, Roger.
Yep, maybe is it Knight's Electronic? I think that is Knight's. Hey, Wainwright, maybe are you back in Last of the Summer's Wine there at the minute, John?
I always get it wrong. I always get it wrong indeed. All right, Wayne House, isn't it? I think that's the man's proper name.
Hi, Jeff there. No, I don't know often there, but I've a friend there would use him. Yep, Knight's Electronics, but who I'm thinking of there, over.
That'd be it, Marty. That'd be a Castle Electronics, that's right, by. No problem at all. I will send the radio over to him, there, Marty, because I like the radio, and I'd like to see it up and going. You know, it was the first really proper HF radio, or at least kind of what you might call a base station that I got. I used to have a Yesu 101 Mark II. The ZD job, but that's an age ago, Marty, Roger.
Yeah, QSL, John. QSL. I know what you're saying there. Yep, I always loved... there's somebody going to hang later behind you. Yep, I used to love that audio there, the Behringer there. When you had the Behringer wired up to that lady. But Jesus, John, I could hear you. I could nearly hear you in Antrim Town, over.
me and the process, and by everything turned up full blast there, Marty. No problem at all. I still have that Behringer. I have to rewire it. I have to rewire it up to the Kenwood. That's something I could be doing now in the next couple of weeks. No doubt about it. No, I managed to disconnect the wires there, Marty, and I never bothered putting them back together again, Roger.
Yeah, QSL, no problem at all. Well, here, a bit of a long time since I did you a wee recording. I just did you a short one there, John. And your call sign, 20, Charlie, Canadian Outlaw, 2130, no?
Hi, that's me, Alito Marty, 29, Canadian Outlaw, 2130, Roger.
Yep, no bother. I just did a wee quick clip there. Yeah, I've sort of slowed down with them, but I'm doing it just that long. I heard you there, Joe. So I'm just doing a quick one there, and I'll get it to you, buddy. You're absolutely shouting the sweet, over.
Oh, that's not too bad indeed, Marty. Yeah, we're trying to keep control on this yoke as regards the ALC, Marty. I do get a wee bit paranoid about that from time to time.